Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to the podcast, RVCCIS.info, where faculty representatives from Rock Valley College's Computers and Information Systems Department talks to you, our community at large, about things roughly having to do with computers and information systems. Howdy, everybody. Joining me today, as always, is Stephanie. I'm Eric. And today we thought we would talk about the least auspicious, not quite unveiling of an already pretty well-known product in the Pixel 6.
Yeah, or the expensive version of the Pixel 5.
Yeah, kind of. So for those of you who are just joining us and don't know about our phone or here, I won't put Stephanie in the same boat as me. I have a phone problem. So we both of us have had numerous Pixel phones, and I think I am a little bit more cool to the experience than Stephanie is. But how do you like the Pixel 5?
It's fine. It's a phone.
See, that's the best praise that you can give a phone. I think that that's not really fantastic. I have a Pixel 4a, and the one thing I bought it for the most was the camera, and honestly, it is nowhere near as good as people say it is in anything but the best lighting conditions, so I really kind of don't use it a lot anymore. I use it primarily as a camera for, you know, webcast stuff. So
yeah, I think my it does have a decent camera. But we have so many devices that it's like we can take our pick what we want. So, but I'm not going to spend $1,200 on a phone. I mean, that's
And I didn't used to want to spend that much, but now that it's the primary camera I use for Barrett, it's like it's probably worth the investment because, you know, we take like however many terabytes, probably not, but it feels like it of pictures a year. So, although I am still rocking my 11 Pro Max, so it's almost 2 years old by now.
So you currently use a Pixel 4?
Yeah, a Pixel 4a, not a 4. So the 4a is like the super cheap version of the camera system from the 4, but really the biggest problem is the processor, and that's something we'll talk about when we talk about the Pixel 6, is it is a very, very underpowered Snapdragon processor. And things like, you know, if you're taking a picture of a moving subject, all you get is blur. The snap-to-snap time is like 2 seconds sometimes. So like the soonest you can, 1, 2, and that's all it takes to lose. Actually, it can be more than that. Lose an opportunity at a picture. It's really not great. And then things like loading web pages goes well sometimes, but then, you know, on kind of heavily JavaScript sites, I'm looking at you, Facebook. There are times where it just refuses to load, and it's because of that super underwhelming Snapdragon chip they have in there.
Well, let's see what 6 has. So I haven't really looked at the specs too much about 6.
Yeah, so while Steph digs for the specs there, we have known, like, so if anybody pays attention to the industry, you know, websites, so things like The Verge or Gizmodo or Ars Technica or things like that, we have had pictures of the Pixel 6 since probably October, I want to say. So nearly a year in front of when they're probably going to release this. And yesterday, just out of nowhere, all of those same periodicals had their, I have my sneak peek at the Google 6 and, or Pixel 6 rather, and Pixel 6 Pro. And they all told the same very well manicured story from Google. So I think, you know, like you're carrying water for Google on their phone.
Yeah. And so I'm on Tom's Hardware. So I found that, the new Tensor chip is the one there.
Right.
they're using. But the so they, there's the 6 and there's the 6 Pro. And basically the difference is memory. So 8 gig of RAM for the Pixel 6 and 12 gig of RAM for the Pro.
Right. So it'd be my expectation, you know, especially with 12 gig of RAM in there, two things, that it's going to be more expensive. So like the Pixel 5 was $500, $600.
Yeah, I think when I bought it, it was even cheaper. I think I paid under $400 for it because I did not.
Yeah, and especially if you do it as like an upgrade through your provider, so probably Verizon, you can get them for, you know, just free now if you, you know, re-up your contract there. So it's not particularly an upper crust phone. It's supposed to be right there at the middle of the market.
The Pixel 5 launched at $699.
So middle of the road, just about. And these almost certainly will not be.
No, it says they could start at $900.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so a grand. Mm-hmm. So more expensive. Really, I think the big, even more so than the RAM there, the reason they're trying to lean on that Tensor chip is to do, I think, a lot of quality of service stuff for Android. So one of the things that Android does is when you look at the way it runs, you get stutters in really strange places where you wouldn't expect to see them in the system. So like when you're switching between apps, when you're opening apps, things like that. And that's because of quality of service. It's the phone is still trying to complete a background task that you might not be involved with, when in fact it could be, you know, dedicating more resources to you, you know, switching apps or whatever that is, opening the app drawer, refreshing something else actively. And I think that that's probably what they're looking for, that Tensor chip to help do, is, you know, maintain some of those things with system on a chip instead of a processor, I suppose, with that SoC, is to help alleviate some of that.
There's a whole bunch of speculation on how long battery will actually be. They're hoping it'll still be an all day battery.
Hoping.
Promising.
Crossed, everybody. Yeah. You know, so I don't know, the Pixel 4a held up all day for battery okay. I mean, I'd be, you know, down under 30% for sure, and that's during a pandemic, so I'm not going out. But I know your Pixel 4, part of the problem was the battery, right?
Three, yeah. And the 5, like, my 5 is always plugged in. I suppose when school starts, that'll be a different story. But like when I do Android audio on my vehicle, I always have to plug it in and it's charging too. So it's really kind of a weird thing. But yesterday I went all day and I didn't charge until I got home. So that was pretty good.
Mm-hmm. And then So I have the big iPhone, and again, I'm here at home, so I'm sure there's opportunities for me to use other devices, but I don't do every other day for charging. It's like the morning of the third day, I'll have to plug it in because it finally dropped under 20%.
And that's the article I read, was like, they're not going to be able to do that.
Yeah. And, you know, it's the same age old issue, I suppose, right? Because Android is built the way Windows is built to be on a whole bunch of different OEM manufacturers, and iOS is built the same way Mac OS is built on their hardware. So they have a really granular control over that. And I don't think, you know, Pixel phones are supposed to be for Google by Google, and they've never really had that same hardware integration.
We've talked about this before. I used to love my Nokia phones.
So. Yeah, or if they didn't, their Nokia is dead. It's they're still alive, but it's really just a basement dish manufacturer. So you'd almost be better off getting like a Motorola at that price point.
Yeah, Well, a friend of mine has a Motorola phone, and let me tell you, the response on it is stupid with the touch screen. It just is ridiculous. There's no way. And that is the nice part about Pixel and iPhone and Samsung, is the response with your touch is fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely.
And when you have them, you don't realize how bad it is elsewhere.
Right. Oh, yeah. Or sometimes when you feel the screen, like just what the glass is made out of, it's like, do you have a screen protector on there? No, it's like, it shouldn't be bending under my thumb. It's very strange.
The other thing is there's a wonder of if that Pixel 6 will come with a charger or if it'll just be wireless.
I guess I'm not so busted up about things not coming with chargers. I have a bunch of nicer, you know, like small 20 watt wall warts. It's like, I really don't care if Apple doesn't ship a crummy 10 watt charger that takes forever. Mm-hmm. I'm not out that much.
Well, and it's using USB-C, so you can actually do that. Mm-hmm. I don't know, so it shouldn't be that big of a deal for us. But then I couldn't imagine, like, if, you know, you're a high school, college student, and you buy yourself a phone and then you don't have a charger, you know.
That's true.
You're upgrading the phone from like an old crappy phone to this one, and then you don't have a charger for it. So that would be
awesome. Right. Yeah, that would be unfortunate. Absolutely. But I'm sort of more excited. I guess I'm ambivalent about the charger, but the reason I buy still Pixel phones, well, we'll see if I do, is the camera. Because again, it is the camera I use. And if this one, they think it's going to be a 50 megapixel with a 4.8 zoom, like a real zoom on it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That would be huge.
Yeah, but you know, the specs on Tom, hold on, let me go back. Yes. So the specs for it, they're saying it's going to be 50 megapixel and then 12 megapixel ultra wide on the Pixel 6. On the Pro, you've got the 48, must be the zoom on it.
And then
your 12 pixel ultra wide. So not too bad. Your front camera obviously is going to be the terrible one.
Yeah,
camera is the one that is the better one.
Yeah, and they've kind of gone back and forth. Google has. They had, I think it was with the Pixel 3, mm-hmm. or maybe it was 4, but they had a really nice ultra wide selfie camera, which makes a lot of sense. And then they got rid of it at the 4A and 5, which was like a shame.
I was looking for my phone to see what. I don't know. I really don't, which I don't take selfies. So, I mean, I don't really, I'm always using my rear camera. And I'm using
Yeah, I don't either, but that was part of the, like the scripted release, which was, you know, just like letting a press or a member of the press into the office and going over exactly the same thing with the 3 major outlets or 5 major outlets. It's like, well, who really cares? But the idea was they'll use that tensor chip with, you know, by mixing exposures to get things like less blurry motion shots or better exposure in like high dynamic range shots. And it's like, I've heard that for years now. I did it for $200 on my Pixel 4 and went like, yeah, shame on me, because that I should have known. And you got to show me first on this Pixel 6.
Yeah, they say there's some other things with the Pixel 6. More cameras than what we have on the Pixel 5, which is just what we went over. The display and refresh rate is supposed to be better.
Mm-hmm.
So the Pixel 6 is supposed to have a 90 hertz refresh rate or 120 hertz to make it a little bit more smooth. But really, it's not that much. I mean, it's just a little bit bigger than the Pixel 5.
Right.
About it, no big deal, other than the chip.
Yeah, other than the chip. And then it's like, is it worth, you know, $300+ to leverage a chip that nobody knows what it's good for yet?
I'm not buying it. Well, I just bought my 5, so.
Right. Yeah, it, and I'm kind of, you got to show me, Google, that's going to be worth a grand, because otherwise I'm out. You know, there's lots of really good Android phones with high megapixels that don't cost anywhere near that much if we get them from, you know, Redmi or Xiaomi or any of those other companies. So, I'm okay. So there you have it, a not quite Google Pixel drop months before the actual Google Pixel drop, but months after the previous unintentional Google Pixel 6 drop. So leave us a comment down below. Let us know whether or not you are sick of, like I am, the promise of future software if you just buy our phones today, spiel that we get from Google sometimes, or if you've had a lot of luck with a Google Pixel phone. I know between all of us, in the CIS department, a lot of us have had them and have, you know, okay or better than okay luck with them. So it'd be interesting to see what you guys think of either your Android phones or your Pixel phones. You can also follow us on social media. We are at RVCCIS Info on Facebook, on Twitter, on anchor.fm, and here on YouTube. We yesterday did publish some stuff about the Google Pixel 6 fake drop that they allowed to be released then. So you can follow us there for more tidbits like that. So on behalf of Stephanie Washer, myself, Eric Wolf, and the rest of the Rock Valley College community, stay safe and stay sane out there, everybody.